Ông quỳ chỗ.
President, please be seated.
Ông chủ tịch chủ đề và các mình to cái tâm lạc can
để tham lạc can. Session and the floor is given to the international deputy co-prosecutor to put questions to this witness. You may now proceed.
Good morning, Mr. President, Your Honours, Counsel, and Mr. Chanman. Good morning. I just have a few questions to follow up from what my colleague has just asked you. Just so that we can get the what you did during the Khmer Rouge period clear, let me ask you a couple of questions. The village that you went to school in, Prang Skia, that was about 12 kilometres from the Kampong Chnang airfield, is that correct?
À quelques kilomètres de Kampong Chnang.
Est-ce exact? Answer, yes, that is correct.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
And you said to the president earlier that you'd spoken to an investigator once about this case, but did you also speak to an investigator again about 9 months after he came to your house and take him to the airfield and show him a few locations where you witnessed some events?
Où vous avez été témoin de certains événements. Est-ce exact?
Did you hear that last question?
Je ne sais pas si vous avez entendu ma dernière question. Le témoin, non, je ne l'ai pas entendu.
Witness, I could not hear your question.
Le témoin, je n'ai pas entendu votre question.
After you gave the statement to the investigator at your house about the events at the airfield,
vous avez parlé.
Did you, some months later, take an investigator to the airfield and show him some places where you saw some events occur at the airfield?
Sur le terrain de l'aviation, vous lui avez montré différents endroits où vous avez été témoin de certains événements. Est-ce exact?
I took that individual to the
réponse.
Airport
site,
and I told him the events that I saw.
Site de travail de l'aéroport, je lui ai dit ce que j'y avais vu.
Thank you, and I'll ask you some questions about those events.
Merci. J'aimerais vous poser quelques questions par rapport à ces événements. Later. Je le ferai un peu plus tard.
You were about 21 years of age in 1975. Can you tell the court whether you were a member of the Communist Party of Kampuchea?
Parti communiste du Kampuchea à l'époque.
Answer.
Réponse.
I did not know then. What I knew is that I was working in the army.
Tout ce que je savais à l'époque, c'est que je travaillais au sein de l'armée.
Mais non, non, pas.
I was not part of the party.
I was working in the army. Je travaillais au sein de l'armée.
Thank you. Did you ever get an opportunity to read the statute of the Communist Party of Kampuchea?
Du Parti communiste du Kampuchea à l'époque?
Answer, no.
Réponse, non.
Thank you.
Question, merci.
You testified that the commander of Division 502 was Comrade Met, and his deputy was a person called Lavey. Is that correct?
Yes, exact.
Answer, yes, that is correct.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
You said that a comrade Met assigned you to work at the airfield.
Vous dites que le camarade
but in your statement, you said that Levay did. Were they both together when you were assigned?
Était-il ensemble lorsque vous avez
who in fact assigned you to the airfield?
Qui a pris la décision? Qui vous a demandé d'aller sur ce terrain d'aviation?
Answer. Initially,
réponse.
It was Levay who told me to.
Au départ, c'est Levay.
Bring my group and accompany the Chinese delegation to that airfield. And later, Met was there, and I was told to take five or six people to help my work. Met arrived at the airfield and I did what I was told by him.
Et j'ai fait ce qu'il m'a demandé de faire.
And how many times had you met comrade Met?
Combien de fois avez-vous rencontré le camarade Met? Combien de fois aviez-vous rencontré le camarade Met?
Answer. I would meet
réponse.
Him sometimes twice a month or in every 3 months. He was staying quite far away from me, so I rarely saw him sometimes.
Il vivait assez loin de moi, donc je le voyais assez peu fréquemment, tous les deux mois ou tous les trois mois.
And when you would meet Comrade Met, would you have conversations with him?
Parliez-vous avec lui?
Man. Answer
réponse,
yes.
Oui.
I had conversation with him. He told and instructed me to perform the assignment or duties, and he asked me what result did I perform.
Quels étaient les résultats que j'avais pu obtenir.
And he also asked about the rocks there at the airfield, and I was told about I was instructed the assignment that I had to do.
Il me posait des questions par rapport aux tâches que je devais accomplir.
And what was your rank
question.
In the army?
Quel
what was your position? Were you a corporal, a sergeant? Did you have a
sergent?
Position, a rank?
Quel était votre grade?
Answer.
Réponse.
I was a messenger in the army.
J'étais messager au sein de l'armée.
No rank.
Je n'avais aucun grade.
I had been in that capacity or in that position until 1979.
J'ai été messager
as I
stated, jusqu'à 1979.
I was the messenger conveying
dit,
messages to units, and I would do my work as
unités.
Told.
Et je faisais ce que l'on me demandait de faire.
And Comrade Met was the
question.
Commander of Division
le
502,
était le
the highest
de la division 502.
Position
c'était le
in
rang,
the division.
Le poste le plus élevé
is
de
that
la
right?
Division. Est-ce exact?
Answer, yes, that is right.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
Did you form a good relationship?
Question.
With Comrade Met,
entreteniez-vous de bonnes
by
relations
the fact
avec
that
le Met,
you spoke to him on a number of occasions.
Sachant que vous êtes entretenu plusieurs fois avec lui.
Answer.
Réponse.
The reason that I was close to him is because
j'étais proche de lui.
I met him frequently when I was in the army. He knew me well
il me
compared
bien
to others.
And
he assigned me to do many tasks when I was at the airfield.
Sur le terrain d'aviation.
Thank you. I'll ask you about those tasks in a moment.
Question.
But can we talk about the deputy commander, Levay, for a moment.
Mais j'aimerais que nous nous attardions sur l'adjoint de Met.
Did you Levay. You worked for Levay before 1975?
Pour Levay avant 1975?
I think for about 3 years, you've said. And you've also
said that you've
worked for
Levay
after 1975 at the airfield.
Vous avez également travaillé pour Levay après
Did you have a good relationship with Levay?
Entreteniez-vous de bonnes relations avec Levay?
Answer.
Réponse.
Before he asked me to perform the duty and task, and later on he
Au départ, il me confia différentes tâches à accomplir.
He was not staying close
Mais
to
par la
my
suite,
place, so
the relationship
became not like before, and I rarely met him but later on, and I was told the duty that I had performed by someone else.
D'autres qui m'a confié des missions.
Are you talking about Question. Now? When you were assigned to operate the radar
on
Phnom Krang Desmiers mountain near the airfield. Is that what you say? Are you saying that you were away because you were working in that mountain?
Que vous étiez loin parce que vous avez travaillé près de cette montagne? Ai-je bien compris?
Answer. Later on,
Réponse.
I was asked to drive a vehicle
l'on m'a demandé de conduire un véhicule
and bring material and
et
equipment up here. No one dares to drive the vehicle, so I was told and assigned
conduire.
To
C'est pourquoi l'on m'a demandé
be stationed at that mountain for a while.
Poste, cette montagne pendant un moment.
Thank you. You also mentioned
Question,
that you were asked to guard
vous avez dit que l'on vous avait demandé de monter la garde
the station at Stung Meng Che after the Khmer Rouge took control
Après
of
la prise de contrôle
Phnom Penh,
de Phnom Penh par les Khmer Rouge,
before you went to the airfield.
Avant de vous rendre sur le
Can you tell us whether Division 502 had a security
si
office at Stung Meng Che.
D'un centre de sécurité à Stung Meng Che.
Answer. Initially,
Réponse.
I was asked to stand guard. And
départ,
later, I was transferred
garde,
to the airfield, so I did not know who else were there.
Mais je ne savais pas qui d'autre il y avait sur place.
Did you ever hear
Question.
Of Division 502 having its own security
dire
office?
Que la division 502
say
avait
where
son
people
propre
may be arrested
sécurité,
and taken there. Did
où
you ever hear of
être
a security office?
Arrêté et emmené. Avez-vous entendu parler d'un tel centre de sécurité?
Answer, I have no idea
Réponse.
About the security office. I did not know about the whereabouts of that security office.
Je ne sais pas du tout où était ce bureau de
sécurité. Thank you. You also
Je
mentioned that
Question.
When you went to the airfield
que lorsque vous vous étiez rendu
that
sur le terrain
you met a person called Uncle Song. Who is Uncle Song?
Song. Qui était-ce?
I do not recall it.
Je ne m'en souviens pas.
Can you tell us who
Question.
The deputy or the subordinate of
Pourriez-vous dire qui était
Levay
l'adjoint
was
le subordonné
at the airfield?
De Levay sur le terrain d'aviation.
Now, no minimum tip. Answer. There was only Chief
of
office. His name was Yang.
Qui s'appelait Yang.
I do not know this individual's full name.
Je ne connais pas le nom complet de cette personne.
What I knew is that Yang was the chief of an office
était le chef d'un
under
bureau.
The supervision of Levay.
Sous la supervision de Levay.
This individual would supervise our work, would meet the assignment at that airfield.
If I can just refer you to your statement, this is D166/116.
Dans votre procès verbal d'audition,
English
at 0029-2824
and 5. Khmer 0028-7529 and French 0035-866. Witness, you were asked this question.
Monsieur le témoin,
who assigned the work, called the meeting and set the plan for the workers at the airport construction site? And you answered, at the beginning, Levay and Song. When more people were sent from the east zone,
Yang
and Levay were in charge of those tasks. Yang disappeared before the Vietnamese fighting in 1979. Does that statement that you gave refresh you, your memory, as to who Song was?
Ce que je viens de lire, ce que vous avez déclaré aux enquêteurs, vous rafraîchit-il la mémoire par rapport à qui était
Song
ce Yang?
Answer. Song was from the same village.
Song venait du même village.
Was a soldier in the 502 as well.
He has passed away.
He was a technician at that time.
Il était technicien à l'époque.
And he was engaged in the training by the Chinese delegation.
Il a participé à la formation de la délégation chinoise.
Did you just forget his name the first time I asked the question, or did I not pronounce it correctly?
Question. Peut-être que je n'avais pas bien prononcé son nom ou vous n'aviez pas compris ma question lorsque j'en ai parlé pour la première fois.
Answer. I recall an individual by the name Song.
Je me souviens de quelqu'un qui s'appelait Song.
He was a villager in the village nearby the mine, and he was in the army.
Et qui servait au sein de l'armée.
You mentioned that after you did the measurements at the airfield, the first time that you you went to Camp Hong Som to collect some more equipment to send to the airfield and I think Siem Reap. And then you said you returned back to the airfield. And my colleague asked you some questions as to how many people were there after you did the measurement and came back. You said there were many hats when you looked across the airfield. Can you explain that a bit more, please, about how many people were there when you came back for the second time?
Retourner là-bas pour la deuxième fois.
Okay. Answer. I saw many people totaling roughly 1,000 workers.
Il y avait peut-être 1,000
there
ouvriers.
Were many workers at the work site, at the various shelters, and at the place
abris.
Where the rock was broken.
Là où l'on brisait la roche.
The first time I was at the airfield, there were
la
not many
fois,
workers, but later on there
terrain,
were female workers as well. They were there to collect rubbish and waste.
Qui s'occupaient de collecter les déchets.
When you went there the first time
question.
To measure
vous avez
the distance for the airfield,
lorsque vous étiez pour la première fois.
Nothing had been built, is that correct?
Rien
you were the first people there
n'est-ce pas?
To start the beginning of the airfield.
Des premières personnes à me rendre right? là-bas pour que le chantier puisse commencer. Est-ce exact?
But answer yes, that is correct. As
réponse,
I stated,
oui,
I was asked to accompany the engineer there, and
on
I was one among the first
group. J'ai fait partie des premiers
and
groupes
I was
à me rendre là-bas.
There with my members. So
je
my role at that time
groupe.
Was to accompany the Chinese delegation so that they could visit and observe the airfield because, as I stated earlier, I was familiar with the
terrain.
Area or location.
And after you went there the first time,
question.
About how long did you stay at the
Après
airfield
cette première fois,
when you did the measurements?
Ou cette première fois, combien de fois? De temps êtes-vous resté sur place pour les mesures?
Answer, after the measurement,
réponse.
As I stated, I was in Jan.
Une fois que les mesures ont été prises,
barrack, I was. I stayed at that barrack, Chancery, for a period of 3 months with a Chinese expert or
avec des experts
engineers.
Et ingénieurs chinois.
And where was that? Was that at Kampong Som?
Question. Vous dites que vous êtes allé à Kampong Som également. À quel moment?
Answer. It was in Kampong Chenang,
Chancery
barrack, or it was referred to the five stories house, which was located close to the old airfield.
And then would you go back and forth to the airfield every day to work?
Faisiez-vous l'aller-retour entre l'endroit où vous étiez et le terrain d'aviation chaque jour?
Bah.
Pour aller y travailler?
Answer. I would
réponse.
Leave for the work site in the morning and
je
I would return together with the Chinese delegation
matin,
during lunchtime and we would go again in the afternoon at 2 p.m.
Repartions à 14 heures pour le chantier.
And that was for about 3 months, is that correct?
Question, et cela a duré environ 3 mois, est-ce exact?
Answer, yes, perhaps
réponse,
so.
Oui,
and
c'est exact.
Afterwards, I was transferred to work
ensuite,
in another place.
Pour aller travailler ailleurs.
You said in your statement
question.
That you were transferred
dans
to collect, collect equipment
vous
at Kampong Song.
Du
how long
Kampong
was that for?
Combien de temps cela a-t-il duré?
Answer.
Réponse.
I do not recall when it was.
Je ne m'en souviens pas. Je ne me souviens pas à quel moment
upon
cela s'est
our produit. Arrivals, we would come back right away on some occasions, and I do not recall how long I stayed
en général,
there
nous repartions immédiatement,
or, you know,
donc je
in
ne
different
sais pas
occasions.
Combien de temps je suis resté là-bas.
And that's what I'm trying to understand for the
question,
for the period that
of
the Khmer Rouge period from April 75
to
January 1979. About how much of your time was spent at Kampong Som receiving equipment and sending equipment to the airfield and other places? About how many trips did you make to Kampong Som during the whole period?
Sur toute cette période.
Answer, I could not recall the trips because I went to Kampong Som rather quite often. I was there many times, so I could not recall
je
them all.
And is it fair to say that they were
question.
Short trips? You would go down to Kampong Som, receive equipment, vehicles, material, and then go straight back to where you were working, if it was the airfield or another place.
Answer. Upon our return from Kampong Sam, I was back in the Chansari barrack in Kampong Chang. I stayed there with the Chinese delegation, so I would go to Kampong Sam back and forth.
Je faisais l'aller-retour à Kampong Sam.
The Chansari building, or the place that you refer to, did you stay there the whole time that you worked at the airfield? Did you always live in those barracks and then go to the airfield each day? Or did you ever live at the airfield itself?
Ou bien pouviez-vous rester sur le chantier de l'aéroport?
Answer. I stayed in the Chansari barracks
at the
so-called five-stories house. Or building.
Ce bâtiment que l'on appelle la maison aux cinq étages.
And is that where all of the Chinese technicians and advisors stayed? Or did they also stay in other places?
Séjournaient ou bien séjournaient-ils ailleurs?
Answer.
Réponse.
The Chinese technician stayed at the so-called five-story building,
séjournaient dans ce bâtiment
and
the
cook
étages.
Stayed in the kitchen
le
in the Chansari barracks, and for my workers, we stayed at the Chansari barracks.
Eux aussi séjournaient dans la caserne de Chansari.
And when you say the Khmer workers,
vous
are you meaning the people that worked at the quarry, the people that worked on the airport site, chopping wood, picking up roots, or are you referring to the supervisors, the supervisors of the workers staying at Chansari barracks?
Des personnes qui surveillaient les ouvriers.
Answer.
Réponse.
Those who worked at the new
les personnes qui
airfield, the supervisor who led the force or work groups stayed in Chansari barracks.
Séjournaient dans la caserne de Chansari.
And as for the newcomers, I mean the new soldiers who were brought into that field, they stayed at the airfield itself.
Restaient sur le chantier.
Thank you. Perhaps if I can summarize a little in relation to what you've testified to and what you have provided in your statement about the Chinese assistance to build the Kampong Chang airfield. Is it fair to say that they provided vehicles, jeeps, steamrollers, other equipment, blasting equipment, technicians, advisors, rock drillers, generators, materials like steel, cement, explosives, throughout the period that the airfield was built, did the Chinese provide that sort of assistance to build it?
Les Chinois ont-ils fourni ce type d'assistance pour la construction de l'aérodrome?
Yes, these materials were from China.
Steel,
everything.
L'acier, tout.
Was the source of Chinese aid.
Voilà le type d'assistance reçue de la Chine.
It was Chinese aid. And as for workers, technicians, they were all from China.
Les techniciens, ils venaient aussi de Chine.
In your statement, you say that at one stage there were 120 technical advisors. Did the number go higher than that in terms of advisors from China, or did it stay about the same?
A dépassé ce chiffre à un moment donné ou est-il demeuré à ce niveau-là?
Thank you, but when you went to cut trees, you took the laborers from the airfield that were living there. Is that correct?
That's exact.
The laborers or the forces for those men from the east zone, whom I took with me to cut trees.
Des gens de la zone est.
And were you told why the east zone workers, military, were sent to Camp Ong Chenang airfield? Why were they selected, the military from the east zone?
Pourquoi avait-on sélectionné des militaires de la zone est précisément?
I do not know the reason. I only knew that those military workers were brought in, and some of them were assigned to me to go and cut trees. And that's all I know about them. So I was given a certain number of these military workers and some tools, and I needed to lead them to cut trees.
In your statement, you say that some of the East Zone workers told you that they were sent to Camp Ong Chenang airfield for refashioning. Do you remember that?
Pour être rééduqués. Ils ont été envoyés à Camp Ong Chenang pour être rééduqués.
Et là, yo mao nè, khi yo mao nè, nó yo một đó thì pram, ai mà vờ đây cái liên
thay hay là and they were told to come to engage in the airport construction work site, and some of them were assigned to come with me to go and cut trees, and there were many of them at the work site.
Perhaps if I can mention what you said in your statement at D-166/116-0029-2823-00-English-0028-7529, that's Khmer, and French 00355866. And you were asked this question: what were the reasons behind the sending and assigning of people from the East Zone for the airport construction? You answered, when Levay assigned me to lead the East Zone workers to clear the forest, they told me that they affiliated to the enemies, their chiefs in the East Zone, who betrayed Ankar and the party, and those chiefs fled to Vietnam. The workers said that the Khmer Rouge sent them for refashioning. Does that refresh your memory as to what the East Zone workers said to you, why they were at the airfield?
Les gens de la zone est lorsqu'ils étaient sur le site de l'aéroport.
I réponse. Recall part of it.
Je m'en souviens en partie.
Because we were all Khmer, and when I saw their unhappy faces,
et lorsque j'ai vu leur visage,
and while we were having meals in the forest, I asked them about the reasons they were sent to the work site, and they looked unhappy. And they told me about the reason I just stated, and I told them, don't have any more worry, just keep doing the work, and we would eat whatever we could afford. And I told them that for the rice and food supply, there should be sufficient for us. And they said half of the force which were originally sent from the zone disappeared, and mainly they were their supervisors or chief, and only the ordinary soldiers arrived. And that's how I learned about the reason that they were sent.
We don't have a lot of time to cover a long period, so let me put a statement that you gave to the investigators about the conditions at the work site for the workers and about arrests that occurred at the work site. And then I'll ask you some questions about that. I'm referring to D166/116, English 0029-2824, Khmer 0028-7528 and 9, and French 0035-5865/5. This was the question that you were asked. Most of the witnesses we interviewed said that many people were sick, died, and taken for killing. And they said that they saw people being tied and trucked away when they worked at the construction site. Please explain your accounts. And you answered, those were the true stories. The arrests were made and the people were being tied every day. I personally witnessed those events. When a list of names of workers was forwarded, one person came to the construction site to tell the victims that they have to go to a meeting. Then the victims were arrested, tied and transported to the direction of Phnom Penh. There were at least three victims in each arrest, and the arrests occurred every day. As far as I know, the persons who made an arrest were not from the construction site, and those orders were not made by Levi or Song. The number of deaths from overwork, exhaustion, hard work also increased from one day to another, as they could not endure the hardest work. The workers committed suicide by running into the roller every week. Most of the suicide victims were female. I did not see any people being killed at the construction site. The corpses of those who died at the construction site were taken to be buried in the forest near Wat Stong. That is what you have told the investigators as to what was happening to workers at the airfield. Can you comment on that? Is that a true account?
Est-ce que ce que vient, ce que vous avez dit est exact? Pourriez-vous faire un commentaire à ce sujet?
I personally saw people being tracked away.
Réponse. J'ai vu des gens être emmenés
and usually they were tracked away at night time. And I heard the sound of the activity from where I stayed. And mostly they were transported to Phnom Penh. And the people who went to take them to Phnom Penh were those from Phnom Penh. And it was an ongoing activity at the time, and everyone was minding his or her own business.
Une activité qui avait cours et chacun s'occupait de ses affaires.
And why were they being taken away?
Et pourquoi les emmenait-on?
I
réponse.
Do not know. The real reason.
J'ignore la vraie raison.
What I saw was those trucks leaving Phnom Penh to go to the airport work site to get those people.
Afin de venir chercher ces gens.
And the people at the work site themselves were not the ones who took them or tracked them out to Phnom Penh.
You were taken away for a time. You were arrested. Isn't that correct?
Également pendant une certaine période, vous aussi avez été arrêté. Est-ce exact?
I was arrested after I returned from cutting trees. I returned in order to come and get a food supply, that is rice.
J'étais venu chercher une ration alimentaire et Yang,
who saw me transporting some large amount of rice because I had men to feed.
J'avais des hommes à nourrir.
And he accused me of transporting rice to the enemy, and I said, if you consider my men were the enemy, I myself would be
alors
the enemy
dit,
as
si
well.
Then
I went to collect some medicines, and next day I was told I had to attend a meeting. And they told me that there was no need for me to get into a vehicle of my team, and that I should get into their vehicle.
Du véhicule avec mon équipe, mais que je pourrais
and
prendre place
I
avant de leur véhicule.
And I was taken to a hospital, and that hospital, still exists today.
Existe encore aujourd'hui.
I was detained, and my hands were tied behind my back, and I was tossed onto a truck,
ligoté, et on m'a
and
jeté
transported
sur un
away. Those people who made the arrest, that is, who arrested me, were not the ones on the ground at the airport. They were people from Phnom Penh. After they kicked my ankle to make me fall down, I fell down, but I had a glance at them and I knew that they were not the people at the work site, but they were people from Phnom Penh. And on the tracks, I could hear sounds of others, people, so I presume they had been arrested before I was arrested, and we were all tracked away on that vehicle.
You mentioned in your statement that people came with lists of names and called people out, and they were taken away. Did you see that occurring? Did you see those names being called out and workers being taken away?
Est-ce que vous avez vu ces gens être appelés puis emmenés?
Before I had been arrested, yes, I did see it.
D'être arrêté, oui, j'avais été témoin de cela.
And if we said that we knew the people whose names were on the list, then they would go to take those people away.
Ces gens-là étaient emmenés.
And sometimes we told the names of the people we knew when we asked, and later in the evening they disappeared.
Et plus tard, dans la
and
nuit,
that included both people who were transferred from the east
cela
zone and some
des
local people
de la,
as well.
De la zone est que des personnes locales.
And why did staff, supervisors from Kampong Chenang Airfield, why did they allow these people coming in from outside
to take
their workers away? Why did they allow that to happen?
President, witness, please hold on, and Councillor Copper, you have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. President. I let it pass a few times already, partly also because the witness used this word himself. However, I think it is it would have preference to refer to the people from the East Zone as soldiers.
Soldiers who had just rebelled,
were involved in massive fighting, and to continuously refer to them as workers, as if they were normal civilians, is, I think, not accurate. Only under certain circumstances the word workers would make sense, but in this specific case I object to the use of the word workers. They were soldiers, they were military people sent from the East Zone after a rebellion.
It's a very nice submission on the defence case. Your Honours, they were soldiers. It's clear they were soldiers, but then they came to work. This is very nuanced.
Soldiers.
Witness, did the East Zone soldiers that were sent to the work site, did they have weapons with them? Did they have guns?
No, they did not. When they were transported in, they did not bring along with any weapon, as their weapons were confiscated.
Les armes étaient confisquées.
Although they came from various units or from the same zone, but none of them had any weapon with them, and the only thing they had with them was clothes.
And for the East Zone soldiers, do you know why their weapons were confiscated?
Saviez-vous pourquoi leur arme avait été confisquée?
Nhóm đang tịch tịch là quạt trạm nhóm.
The new part of the event, I was told by those workers with me in the forest that they were accused of having a connection to the enemies. But as I said, I was simply an ordinary worker, and I didn't know the real details behind that. And the only reason that I learned was from those workers while we were cutting trees in the forest. And at a quiet time, I asked them about this, and that's what I was told.
Thank you. I would like to talk a bit about some of these arrests, and you said that you heard that these, well, you saw that these arrests were occurring, and that trucks were taking people away. In your statement or in a crime site report,
du site de crime,
and I'm referring to.
Et là je parle du document
D232/100 English 0043-6946 and Khmer 0042-8465 and English 0048-5452 I think there's an objection.
No objection, just a request to not refer to D documents numbers, but to the E3. That would be much more practical for us to find it quickly.
We will do that, Your Honour. I don't have the E number right now, but I will obtain it for you. This is what the investigator said. This is what the investigator said that you said to him when you took him to the airfield in 2010. He said that you pointed out a site to the northwest of Kampong-Chenang airfield, about 180 meters from the location where you formerly lived during the Democratic Kampuchea period, and about 3 kilometers from the airfield's runway. A large tree is at that site. In 1977, he saw trucks carrying troops leave the airfield at night between 10 p.m. and midnight. The troops were brought to that site, and about 5 minutes later, you heard screams and crying emanating from that location. Several days later, you smelt the odor of decomposing bodies coming from that site. The witness still recognizes that tree today, which is now in its original state. At that site, the investigator was unable to see the signs of grave pits, but he is suspicious about circular marks at 2 or 3 locations near the tree. If I can put one of those photos that were in that crime site report on the screen, I'll ask you a few questions about that.
De ce site.
Just for our technician, that's slide one.
Il s'agit de la diapositive
but
numéro
whilst,
un,
whilst this is happening, you said that you lived in Chansari in Kampong-Chenang town whilst you were working at the airfield, and then you would travel there every day. And then from what the investigator has said that you have said is that you used to live in a building that was called the transportation unit, which was about 3 kilometers to the west of the airfield. Can you explain, did you live in two places, one at the transportation unit and the other in town, in Kampong-Chenang town, with the Chinese?
It happened only after I went to transport woods, and while I was undertaking the terrain measurement, I stayed at the Chansari barrack. And only later on, when I transported woods to the sawmill, I stayed at that building you mentioned.
Que j'habitais dans le bâtiment que vous venez de mentionner.
And about 300 to 400 meters behind where I stayed, there was a stream located near Wat Steng Pagoda, and there was a big tree there. I heard screams coming from that direction. And later on, when I trespassing the area, I noticed the odor coming from that area. However, I did not see corpses. I only smelled the odor, and that big tree still exists.
Et ce grand arbre
and
existe
I
toujours.
Also accompanied the OCIJ investigator to that site. But we only
Mais
saw the big tree and some bamboo trees, but we did not
bamboo.
See any pits.
Le fosse de charnière.
If we can look at D322/100, ERN 0043-6952, Khmer 0042-8469, in French 00455-457, a picture 4 on the screen. Can you just explain what you see in that picture?
À l'écran, pourriez-vous nous expliquer ce que vous y voyez?
The photo shows the area behind the location where I transported the wood.
And if we can look at the second slide, please. And that's ERN 0043-6952 in the English. Can you explain what you are doing in this photograph? What you are pointing to?
Qu'est-ce que vous montrez?
I am pointing to the big tree.
Je suis en train d'indiquer du doigt le grand arbre.
At the far distance.
Qui se trouve au loin.
You can see that there is only one big tree.
On voit qu'il n'y a qu'un seul grand arbre.
At the background of the photo.
And if we can show the next slide, please. 0043-6951. It's English
si
photo. And
Mr.
President, I would ask that the
0040,
photo stay on the screen if possible.
Et Monsieur le Président, j'aimerais que la photo reste à l'écran, si c'est possible.
It's been flashing up and then flashing off.
Parce que pour l'instant, elles apparaissent, elles disparaissent aussitôt.
President, yes.
President,
your request is granted.
Très bien.
Looking at this slide, what are you showing us in this photo?
Sur cette photographie, qu'êtes-vous en train de nous montrer?
This is the area where I heard the screams.
L'endroit d'où venaient les cris.
And if we can show the last slide, which is English 0043-6951. If you can tell us what you see in this photo, it will come up shortly.
Near the big tree on the day that I accompanied the
de l'arbre, le jour où j'ai accompagné
investigator,
les enquêteurs,
we saw
nous avons vu
the circular marks, which could be the marks of the former pits
des marques d'anciennes
from the that regime. And as I said, this is the area where I heard the screams emanating from and where I smelled the bad odor. And the screams from this area, I heard it almost every night while I was staying in the area. However, the location is an open field now. But the big tree still stands, and there's still some bamboo trees along the stream.
You said that you heard it almost every night. How often did you stay in the transportation unit, in that building we've just seen?
Séjourniez-vous dans le bâtiment que l'on vient de voir, le bâtiment de l'unité du transport?
On the day that I returned to sleep there, I heard the screams. But allow me to say that I did not sleep at that transportation unit every night. I only slept when I could not make a return trip. So after I dropped the boots off, I would return. But for some days, it was too late, so I stayed overnight. And that's when I heard screams coming from this area.
And can you give us an amount about how many times you heard these incidents occurring in the evening?
It varied, and I cannot recall it all, as you know, it's been several years.
Je ne peux pas m'en souvenir.
And
beaucoup
the
d'années se
situation
depuis.
At that time was rather confusing as well. And I myself had to be mindful of where I was going.
Moi-même, je ne faisais
and
pas
I could not
tell
you the number of different screams coming from this area when I heard it.
Thank you. Mr. President, I have about two or three
Merci.
More minutes
Monsieur
on this topic.
I
believe you normally break
sujet.
At 11:30. I'll continue. Thank you. You said that you heard the screaming. For about how long would you hear the screaming? Was it quick? Was it 1 minute, 5 minutes, 10 minutes? Can you tell us how long it was?
The screaming lasted for about 3 or 4 minutes,
j'ai entendu ces cris
and sometimes it was shorter than that,
parfois,
maybe 2 or 3 minutes. Then I could hear the sound of the truck returning.
Ensuite, j'entendais le son du camion qui revenait.
In this report, it says that you told the investigator that you would see the trucks carrying troops come towards that location. Where would you see those trucks come from?
D'où venaient ces camions?
The trucks came from the other side of the mountain, while I was on the opposite side of the mountain.
Moi, j'étais sur le versant opposé.
I heard the sounds of the trucks, and I heard the sound of its turning at the corner.
Qui tournait au virage.
And of course, the area that I stayed in was closer to the area that I heard the screaming emanating from.
And was the airfield between the transportation unit and the mountain you referred to?
Entre l'unité de transport et l'endroit que vous avez mentionné.
The transportation unit
L'unité des
was in between the mountain. As when I worked for while I was cutting trees, I was at the other side
Lorsque
of the mountain,
des arbres, je
and the distance
côté
was
de
about
la
3 to 4 kilometers.
À 3 ou 4 kilomètres de là.
How did
Question.
All of this screaming, trucks arriving,
tous ces cris, les
the smelling
arrivaient.
Of decomposing bodies,
l'odeur des cadavres en décomposition.
Experiencing that on a regular basis, how did that make you feel?
Le fait que vous ayez été témoin de cela régulièrement, quel sentiment a-t-il provoqué chez
President
vous?
President Witness, please, the word and defense counsel.
Maître Veuillet, s'il vous plaît, Maître Antagisset, la parole, dit le président.
Si je ne m'abuse, en tout cas dans ma traduction, je n'ai pas entendu le témoin parler d'odeur, de corps en décomposition, il a juste parlé d'odeur. Il me semble que M. le procureur rajoute des éléments. Donc j'objecte à la question.
Your Honour, it may be a translation issue, but it's certainly not something that I'm adding. As you know from the report, it says he smelled the odour of decomposing corpses coming from that site. But to clarify, can I ask you that again? I read this passage out to you. You've said to the investigator that you smelt odor of decomposing bodies. Is that what you smelt
de corps en décomposition, de cadavres en décomposition, est-ce bien ce que vous avez dit aux enquêteurs ou pas?
Because when the wind was blowing through my direction, that was the stench or the strong odor that I smelled.
So, Mr. President, if I just finish that last question, how did the smells, the screaming,
donc les cris,
the trucks arriving every night that you were there, how did that make you feel?
Comment vous sentiez-vous à ce moment-là? Quel sentiment cela a-t-il provoqué chez vous?
During the night that I stayed there,
réponse.
I heard the screaming.
Les nuits que je passais là-bas,
and, personally,
je pouvais entendre
at the time,
cris.
I did not feel any good.
Et personnellement,
I did
je
not
me
know which day my turn would come.
Je me demandais
that's how I felt
quand
at the time.
Mon tour à moi viendrait. Voilà ce que je ressentais.
Because from what I saw, workers there were asking themselves when our day would come. That is the day that we would be killed or died. We were just waiting for the day. That's the bad feeling that we had.
Voilà,
despite the food that we were given, we did not have the happy feeling at all.
Certes, l'on nous nourrissait, mais nous n'étions
Thank
pas
you,
heureux.
Mr. President.
L'accusation. Merci, Monsieur le Président. Le Président.
President,
merci.
Thank you. It is now appropriate for our noon break. We take a break now and resume at 1:30 to continue our proceedings. Court officer, please assist the witness at the waiting room for witnesses and experts during the lunch break and invite him to leave. Courtroom again at 1:30 this afternoon. Security personnel, you are instructed to take his phone back to the waiting room downstairs and have him return to attend the proceedings this afternoon before 1:30. The court is now in recess.